प्रति अपनी प्रतिबद्धता को ध्यान में रखते हुए विश्वविद्यालय अनुसूचित जाति और जनजाति के बेरोजगार विद्यार्थियों को स्नातक डिप्लोमा और सर्टिफिकेट स्तर पर चलने वाले अकादमिक कार्यक्रमों में शुल्क में छूट प्रदान करता है।
अपने 10 क्षेत्रीय केंद्रों, 532 विद्यार्थी सहायता केंद्रों तथा 4144 शैक्षिक परामर्श द्वारा पूर्वोत्तर क्षेत्र के शैक्षिक विकास में, क्योंकि हमारी संस्कृति देश की आत्मा है, करुणा, संभाव, प्रेम, सहिष्णुता, समरसता, त्याग, परोपकार की भावना से हम विश्व को नेतृत्व
करता हूँ कि उन्होंने हमारे आमंत्रण को स्वीकार किया और इस अवसर की
विद्यापीठ के निदेशकों से निवेदन करूंगा कि डिग्री और डिप्लोमा प्राप्त करने वाले सभी विद्यार्थियों को प्रस्तुत करें।
20 विद्यार्थी क्षेत्रीय केंद्रों पर व्यक्तिगत और अनुपस्थित रूप में आपके
Diploma. ह्यूमन रिसोर्स मैनेजमेंट डिप्लोमा इन इंटरनेशनल बिजनेस ऑपरेशन रूमा भारती पीजी डिप्लोमा इन मैनेजमेंट
रूपी मास्टर ऑफ आर्ट्स इंग्लिश संस्कृति सिंह मास्टर ऑफ साइंस हॉस्पिटैलिटी एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन महाला मास्टर ऑफ लाइब्रेरी एंड इंफॉर्मेशन साइंस सुमैया बशीर मास्टर ऑफ आर्ट्स पब्लिक एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन अंकिता मोहंती मास्टर ऑफ आर्ट्स सोशियोलॉजी वर्सेलिन टेलस मैरिए Bachelor of Science, Nursing, Post Basic. Vijita Robinson, PG Diploma in Intellectual. Rashi Dubey, PG Diploma in Pre-Primary Education. Sakshi Sharma, PG Diploma in Pharmaceutical Sales Management. Sarda Prasad, PG Diploma in Rural Management. Manish Kumar Saroha, PG Diploma in School Leadership and Management. Raj Kamal Yadav, PG Diploma in School Leadership and Management. Ravikant Verma, PG Diploma in Translation. Sanjay Chaudhary, PG Diploma in Urban Planning and Development. Jerin Joy, PG Diploma in Journalism and Mass Communication.
Philosophy in Statistics. Mahmoud
Thank you.
Raju sir, Regional Director, Regional Center, Vatakara, to kindly address the gathering.
The most honorable guest of honor of the day, Professor Ramachandran Alappat, the very honorable and distinguished Vice-Chancellor of KUFOS, my colleague and Regional Director, of IGNOU Regional Center, Cochin, Dr. J.S. Dorothy, my colleagues at the Regional Center, Vatakara, Dr. Pramila O, my colleagues from Regional Center, IGNOU Cochin, Dr. Sindhupi Naya, Dr. Jarajagumari, Dr. Prasida Unikrishna, and Dr. Vijay Raghavan, and Section Officer Mr. K.J. Joseph, Mr. K.K. Joseph, our Assistant Registrar, Mr. Chandrasekhar, Mr. Murali, and all other members of the staff of IGNOU Regional Center, Cochin, of course. I'm not leaving out Manju, Philomena, and all others as well. It is my proud privilege and pleasure to address you all on this very solemn occasion. I shall also not forget to mention the name of Dr. Divakar Nair, our guide as well as philosopher who had taken us forward in the journey which is IGNOU. I also see a number of our coordinators, both from Regional Center Cochin as well as Regional Center Vatakara. May I mention the name of our Abdul Majid sir, our Tom Varghi sir, and also all others who are present here whose name I may not remember. And I also partly remember the name of Mr. Joji from the Regional Evaluation Center. Now I am supposed to offer you with the proceedings and events which have taken place at RC Vatakara in the last 1 year. It is indeed a pleasure and an honor to stand here in Cochin, and that too under the auspices of Regional Center Cochin, because it is one institution at which I have worked for 4.5 years and I have very fond memories of the same. Coming to my Regional Center, that is Regional Center Vatakara. As you all know, Regional Center Vatakara is perhaps the baby IGNOU Regional Center because it was formed only in the year 2011. But that definitely does not mean that it is a regional center with any less importance than any other. One of the greatest achievements of Regional Center Vatakara, not only in the past 1 year, but also over a period of time, that is the period of around 10 years that we have been in existence, is in fact the fact that we have been able to change the course of discourse that has emanated in Malabar region. I will give you a simple example how we have changed this discourse, that we, academic discourse rather, that we have in the Malabar region. Before we came as a regional center at Vatakara for Malabar region and of course for Mahi as well, we have seen the condition that many people, many institutions were not willing to venture into organizations such as jails. We established a jail center at Kannur Central Jail, and today the condition is that more and more institutions are taking a cue out of our book and are willing to offer programs in Kannur Central Jail. This is just one of the examples that IGNOU Regional Center Vatakara has to offer in this regard. Then IGNOU Regional Center Vatakara, many of you who have come to that place and visited our regional center over there may say that we lack an infrastructure, but that's not the truth. We are perhaps one of the richest regional centers as far as land is concerned. Government of Kerala and Maniyur Gram Panchayat has given us 2 acres of land to construct our building, and I am sure in due course we will have a beautiful building in that place, and we shall all vacate the present premises and move on to that place. Just because we lack in certain infrastructure, that has not prevented us from doing our duty to the fullest extent possible. Some of the innovations that we have brought out in IGNOU Regional Center Vatakara are noteworthy, to say the least. One, we have introduced an interactive e-portfolio whereby the students can directly interact with the regional center on a digital mode. And one of the key elements of this interactive e-portfolio is the fact that we have introduced a system of virtual queue. Now, many of you would be, in fact, aware of the virtual queue system that exists at various other places. The most important example, or the most famous example of the virtual queue, is basically at Shabrimala. We have taken a queue out of that and we have introduced a virtual queue in IGNOU Rail Center, Vatakara. The advantage being that the student can schedule a kind of audience with the officer or official that he wishes, get the time, come to the regional center with the token that is electronically generated, come there and meet the concerned official and go back to her, his or her satisfaction. Another important milestone as far as the digital endeavors of IGNOU Rail Center Vatakara is concerns the virtual classroom that we have introduced, and that too on the YouTube platform. Many of you would not be knowing that we at the Region Center Vatakara have a virtual classroom operating on the YouTube platform. And distance learners are supposed to be at a distance, but we, through this YouTube classroom, we introduce certain point-based and targeted videos, and these videos are all made with the help of voluntary contributions from the academics of Malabar region, and we put it on.
Aims of that particular mechanism is that we are trying to introduce some of the videos in Malayalam language itself, so that those who are facing some kind of a difficulty with English language or other media of studies, they can actually watch these videos and enhance their understanding. This is definitely at the stage of infancy, but we have it for material handling as well as for SMS handling. Now, we all know that there has been a change in system whereby some of the study material comes to the regional centers where we are supposed to manage it.
I wouldn't say Shakespearean in English, but definitely with an English that was pleasing to the ears. So that was another successful program done by IGNOU Regional Center Vatakara. But the program which lies closest to my heart is the kind of intervention that we made for the benefit of specially abled children in Ashramiketan, an institution which is dedicated for the welfare of mentally challenged children operating from Nandi. We, along with our team, and I'm proud to say Mrs. Pramila is also here, who was also instrumental and part of this particular program. We went in, we had no preconceptions. We went there and we started a kind of module-based computer literacy program for mentally challenged children, and the biggest takeaway for us was the smiles that we could generate on the faces of each and every student that we could see there. And still, we have not stopped that process. We are working on further game-based development programs, and definitely this intervention will continue. And as long as I feel, as long as the Region Center remains there, we will definitely take it forward to its logical conclusion. Now, this is one of the examples that I could highlight, and as I already said, was close to my heart. Another area that we have worked on is the computer literacy program. We have aggressively sought to introduce this computer literacy program in Vatakara and nearby areas, and we have achieved reasonable success in this matter. There's another area, and another major area of our intervention has been at Kannur Central Jail. Now, we have academic programs running at Kannur Central Jail, but in addition to that, what we did differently was to introduce certain module-based intervention programs or extension programs there. And one of these was the soft skill training program for inmates of Kannur Central Jail. And it was well received, and the peer and the inmates were very happy with that particular program. We also did a computer literacy program there, which again was well received. And the icing on the cake was the program we did on World Health Day. We had a session, a very useful session, with professionals in the field coming to Kannur Central Jail and doing a module-based program on first aid training. And that is very important for jail inmates, because often within jails you don't have enough experts to cater to the first aid needs of inmates. and there we intervened, and that has also yielded good results. Now, this is not all as far as IGNOU Regional Center Vatakara is concerned. We have collaborated effectively with other institutions as well to spread the light of knowledge. And one such program has been the very intensive program which we did to enhance the skills of the teachers of Calicut University, the School of Distance Education. It was the first of its kind of consultancy program that we introduced, and I am happy to say that in that program, our assistant regional director from IGNOU Regional Center, Cochin, was earlier at Vatakara, Dr. Jaljammari, also took part, and a number of professionals in the field also came together, and we could actually train the teachers of Calicut University in many of the softwares and digital literacy related aspects, and that was also a major success. Now, any regional center would be judged by the enrollment that it has and the progress in the enrollment that it obtains over a period of time. If we take our case, let us take 2017 as the benchmark year. If we take that year, our total enrollment was 10,621. Now, when we came to 2018, our enrollment rose to 15,545. And in the year 2019, all of you would be very, very happy to know that our enrollment stood at 18,562. So this is a regional center which is making progress year by year, minute by minute, and moment by moment. Let's make no doubt about that in our mind. If you take the current year statistics, I bet it would have reached around 55 to 60%. So the progress made by the women community as far as inclusion in our programs is also substantial and very effective. So that itself shows how valid and how effective our intervention has been in Malabar area. We have created a paradigm shift as far as thinking of institutions is concerned. Malabar area does not have the dearth of institutions. It has very reputed institutions including the IEM and REC. However, the way that we have intervened in the social fabric of Malabar area is in fact unique and needs to be commented upon. And this has not been possible just with our efforts alone. As we all know, institutions prosper only when we walk on the shoulders of giants. And RC Vatakara is no different. We have been fortunate to have the services of very efficient officers at Regional Center Vatakara before me. And after me also, there will be lot many officers coming in and enhancing the goal of RC Vatakara. Let me mention a few of them. Dr. Shanmugam, who is at present the Regional Services Division Director, was also a regional director there. And he had made yeoman contribution to this institution. Dr. Pani Selvam, my predecessor, he also had contributed a great deal to the prosperity and well-being of IGNOU RC Vatakara. Further, it is also my profound pleasure to mention the name of ARDs who had worked before us there. Let me mention the names of Dr. Zarina, Dr. Jaljammari, as well as Dr. Sita Kapoor, who had profoundly contributed for the development of that particular region center. Further, our academics at the region center, our officials at the region center have also not taken a back step as far as academic activities outside the institution is concerned. Our ARD, Dr. Pramila, had attended refresher programs last year as well as one short-term program to enhance her skills so that it is beneficial for our regional center. Further, the academics at the regional center, including me, have taken part in various training programs at human resource development centers and other places, and we have tried to impart skills beyond IGNOU as well. If you take the numbers as such, the last 1 year itself in human resource development training programs conducted by UGC itself, we have had the participation at 8 places as resource person. So that is quite a good number as far as a team of 2 academics is concerned. Further, we have also worked as resource persons in various conferences sponsored by NAC, UGC and various other institutions. In fact, I am proud to say that we have also been part of faculty development programs at CUSAT on more than a couple of occasions. Plus, we have also tried our best to enhance the faculty caliber of institutions such as Nirmala College by Nirmala College Mavatuvida by conducting workshops and training sessions as well. So, IGNOU Regional Center Vadagara has had this ability and will always have this ability to boom beyond the borders of the regional center. And we will always be a contributory fact in the development of Kerala society as such. Nothing of this would have been possible without the wholehearted support of my staff over there, starting with Dr. Pramila, Dr. Praveen, and also the contractual staff. And if you allow me, I will name them. Mr. Roshan, Ms. Anuja, who is here and who shall be receiving the degree today, master's degree today. Ms. Stella, Archana, Sumesh, Mithun, Srihari, Siji, Vini, Deepa, Ashit, Neetu, and Shijit. Their contribution has been paramount in establishing IGNOU Regional Center Vadagara as a premier education institution in Malabar. Now, the importance of their work lies in the hard work they are willing to put in beyond office hours. They take IGNOU as a matter of pride, and that's the reason why we have been able to make this progress. Now, coming to you students, today is a very proud day for all of us. You will soon be holding degrees, diplomas and other qualifications in your hand. Now, as I said, with great power comes great responsibilities. You are being given a great power in terms of the qualifications that you will be holding in a few minutes' time. However, the responsibility that is bestowed upon you is much, much more important. The reason being that in India, there is a whole group of underprivileged people who are not in a position to actually access the kind of education that you, each and every one of you, has access. So it is your duty to actually go beyond your mandate and move into the society and provide the skills and other qualifications that you have acquired till date and spread the light of knowledge in the minds of the students that and other people in the society that you will be facing from today on. Now, what you do with your degrees and other qualifications is very important. Some degrees and qualifications have a natural way of expanding their welfare into the minds and hearts of people across wherever you stay. For example, a medical degree. What people would often ask me, is it possible with an arts degree? Yes, it's very much possible with an arts degree or whatever degree you hold. The intention that you have, the belief that you have, the confidence that you have, and all that you have generated through this degree should serve as a beacon for all people who are near you. Your fame should spread beyond the borders of the state and beyond the borders of the country. I am sure many of you, not only from RC Vadagara but also from Cochin, will take the name of IGNOU much beyond the borders of this country. Wherever you go, you will be branded as an IGNOU student, a IGNOU degree holder. Please remember that. Your behavior, your achievements are also a patch on IGNOU and its achievements. So, you have a duty not only to reach out to the wider society and the world at large, but also to remain in touch with your alma mater and also contribute positively to the development of the alma mater whenever that is required. Now, this is something very important. Institutions develop and institutions prosper only through their students. Whatever we do at the regional centers, if you don't take the name of IGNOU forward in a very positive way through your contribution, through your work in the society, institution such as IGNOU will never have a big name. It is your duty to be perfect brand ambassadors of IGNOU, and I'm sure each and every one of you will be that and very much that. In fact, I would like to congratulate our gold medalist from RC Vatakara, Mr. Muhammad Salim, who through his hard work has shown that the students of IGNOU Regional Center Vatakara are second to none. And for that matter, IGNOU Regional Center Cochin as well. We can be the best not only in the country but also across the world. There is absolutely no doubt as regards that. A few years from now, we will see a few of you at least emerging as civil servants, scientists, and you will be moving to the top entrance of the society. At that time also, remember that you owe a debt to IGNOU and to the society. As long as you keep that in your mind, you will not falter in your life. Now, a word about the close collaboration between IGNOU Regional Center Vatakara and IGNOU Regional Center Cochin. We are fraternal institutions, and IGNOU Regional Center Vatakara can very much claim that IGNOU Regional Center Cochin has been its mother or father, as your preference goes. This regional center at Vatakara emerged out of this regional center which exists at Cochin. So we are eternally thankful for the yeoman work that IGNOU Regional Center Cochin had done before the formation of IGNOU Regional Center Vatakara, because when we opened an IGNOU Regional Center at Vatakara, you already had a name in place, and that is because of the wonderful work done by the staff and people associated with IGNOU Regional Center Cochin. And let me mention the name of Dr. K. Sivakaran, who had been the regional director for a long time, and he had taken the name of IGNOU Regional Center far and wide into the Malabar region. And as I already stated, there are very many fond memories as far as IGNOU Regional Center Cochin is concerned associated with me. And one of the fondest memories that I have is the creation of a MOOC for the SWAYAM platform. A team comprising of me, our assistant regional directors here, Dr. Sindhu P. Nair, Dr. Jalita Umari, and Dr. Prasida Unnikrishnan, we were instrumental in creating one of the first MOOCs in the country. That is the certificate program in environmental sustainability. And add to that, till date, that remains the only MOOC from any regional center in the country. And that shows the kind of close collaboration and hard work that these two regional centers have had. Of course, at that time, I was the regional director of RC Cochin, but still, till date, that program is running, and it is an epitome of the close collaboration that we have between the two regional centers. And I'm eternally thankful to my team members who have actually worked behind it and put in their hard work. And I'm also thankful to our region director madam who has promoted this program much better than I could have at RC Vatakara. Now, there is no shortcut to hard work. Before I conclude, I would like to tell you two stories. One is regarding hard work, and the other one is regarding the importance of teachers in our life. Hard work always pays. And our Honorable Minister was right in stating that jinki who actually do hard work, they never fail. I'll give you a simple example, and this is a dated example. That is the example which moves far into history. Many of us would have heard about Hannibal, the Carthaginian general. And it was one time when it was considered that Rome was invincible. You could not have imagined at that time that you could defeat Rome with an army. From Carthagena, this general believed that a small state like Carthagena could defeat Rome. And what did he do for that? You all know the Alps Mountain. And it is one of the coldest places on earth. To give a surprise to the Roman army and its empire, this general took an army of 10,000 elephants in those times from the African jungle with another 50,000 men, climbed the Alps mountains, and in cold winter, he circumvented all difficulties and reached the valleys of Rome. Now, by the time he reached there, only 4,000 elephants were left with him, and only 15 or 20,000 men. Still, the surprise element was so big that the Roman army, no matter how big it was, could not withstand the onslaught of the Carthaginian army. And Rome was defeated for the first time in history with an alien army entering its shores. So that is what hard work can actually do. That is what, in fact, planning can help you. And that is what we should all do in our lives. Think of the impossible, work for the impossible, and impossible will always be yours. And let me finally give you a reminder that teachers are very important. We talk about the distance education system, and sometimes we often feel that teachers are not an important part of this system. No, I wouldn't agree with that. Because it is the teachers who meet you in the counseling sessions on Saturdays and Sundays who give you a path to go ahead. Now, we all must have heard about Sachin Tendulkar. I am sure none of you, we don't have any person in this hall who hasn't heard about Sachin Tendulkar. Now, when we first went to Madras Space Academy or MR Space Academy, there we met Dennis Lilly, the legendary coach and cricketer and a great pace bowler. Tendulkar wanted to become a pace bowler. Dennis Lilly asked him to take a run up and bowl a couple of balls. And then Dennis Lilly, in fact, asked him to bat and show him how his efficiency at batting was. Immediately, Dennis Lilly could identify that this was the person who would make a batting history for India. And he said, never even think about being a bowler. You have to go to a good coaching batting coach and become a good batsman. And that's how Ramachandran became the full-time coach of Sachin Tendulkar, and the rest is history. I rest my words here. Thank you for giving me a patient listening, and all the best.
My may now request Regional Director, Regional Centre Cochin, Dr. J.S. Dorothy Madam, to kindly address and present the report of Regional Centre Cochin. Friends, the detailed report is available and will be available in the website, which can be downloaded and read. But for the ease of hearing, I am just shortening the report. Guest of honor of the convocation, Professor A. Ramachandran, Vice-Chancellor PUFAS, distinguished educationalists, academicians, guests, members of everyone on the dais and off the dais. We welcome you to this 33rd convocation. Whatever has been dealt and shared by Regional Director Vatakara related to Swayam, it's overlap. I am not covering it in my report, even though we are part of that event. The detailed bio data of the Chief Guest of Honor is also there in our website. And before starting, as we say, we honor the establishment of the Regional Centre Cochin, and we recall with gratitude the contribution by the founding fathers like Professor Satya Palan. He was the founding regional director, and Dr. V. Vasudevan, former regional director, and Dr. K. S. Divakar Nair, who is with us now, is also former regional director, in whose tenure the regional center moved to own premises and its habits development of building large enough to house the regional center, regional study center, that is the model study center and the regional evaluation center. Special efforts of the former regional director, Dr. M. Shanmugam, who is currently the director of regional services division, Dr. V. Venkop already, who was formerly our director of regional services division, Dr. M. Rajesh, currently Regional Director at Vatakara, and Dr. Sindhu P. Nair, who is with us at Cochin now, in sustaining the vision of the founding fathers and the mission of which the university was created in the year 1985. And I just mentioned this, in 1988, this Cochin came into existence, and we cover six areas, including the Lakshadweep Union Territory. And I'm just presenting it to you based on the snap format which they asked for it. So we, related to the teaching and learning, we have a network of learner support centers ranging from program study center, the regular study center, and also the special study center. And we have 87 academic programs being activated in the 34 learner support centers at the Cochin Regional Center. And at present, we have the cumulative student strength of 25,210 learners for July 2019.
and that was the last session, and Jan 2020 is under finalization. We have extension up to the end of the month, so we are not covering that in the report. And under the teaching learning activity, we have the orientation program for the academic counselors, and we also have the meeting of the learner support center functionaries, where mainly in terms of the coordinators and also the part-time staff. And we have conducted it and coordinated by Dr. P.T. Jarja Kumari, even though the resource persons are drawn in-house from all offices. And related to the extension activities, we have the UP activity with the nodal officer of Dr. Sindhu P. Nair. And for the Swachh Bharat Abhiyan, Dr. S. Vijayaraghavan, ARD, is the nodal officer. And the collaboration organized, noted worthy to be mentioned in this report, are with the block development office to mobilize street samplings, which was coordinated by Dr. V.T. Jalaja Kumari. They gave free samplings, which were distributed under the One Student, One Tree campaign under RC Cochin, and with the district collectors to adopt the six villages. Among the six villages, we have conducted five villages awareness about not using the plastic and how to recycle the waste. This was coordinated by Dr. Sindhu P. Nair. And promotional initiatives, the consolidation of the reports were done by Dr. Prasita Unnikrishna. And we have targeted both the learner support center and also the other educational system institutions which are not the learner support centers of IGNOU. And through the IQACSL and also through AARFM radio, we were able to promote IGNOU programs. And promotion is one of the backbone for our increased enrollment. Credit goes to all the academics at Regional Center, Cochin. And resource person for open cum enrichment session under Innovation Club was always clubbed with the grievance redressal cell. So in other words, we have every month the grievance redressal cell and also the Innovation Club enrichment session. The in-house, all the academics served as the resource person. And the external resource person, we are grateful to acknowledge the efforts of Dr. A.K. Prema, Coordinator, Model Study Center, which is functioning from her campus. She mobilized some external members to be used as for this innovation club. And also our assistant registrar, Dr. K.K. Joseph, he also helped us to mobilize, especially from the banking sector, which was well welcomed by the audience. And academic initiatives were possible for two people, one is with the Vidyodhya School and another with the QSAR, without financial responsibility, liability on IGNOU. And we are also grateful to this All India Radio. It is transmitting our Gyanavani program and also help us to be a resource person for the AARFM radio under to create awareness about IGNOU programs. And continuing our education opportunities for academics was also in vogue in RC Cochin. And all the four academics have attended either a FDP or a refresher program as a means to add credit to them and also increase the profile of them in the scenario of an academic institution. And they have also participated in conferences, and they have also shared the knowledge or the resource by academics by being either a resource person in an FDP program or by publication in a referate journal. And the Gandhi Jayanti celebrations at Regional Center Cochin was converted into cleaning by India Mission, and so we were making our regional center campus plastic free, and this was made possible through the efforts of Model Study Center, the Regional Evaluation Center staff, and also the Regional Center staff. And Water Day celebration was also made possible on 24th January. And we were able to say how, as a citizen, we have to be a voter first. And this was coordinated by Dr. K.K. Joseph, and the Regional Evaluation Center Section Officer Dr. S. Venkopal, also was shared the certain thoughts which were useful to the gathering. And official language training through the Hindi teaching scheme, we are also on the list. And we are also happy to say that almost all in Cochin Regional Center have the knowledge of Hindi, both to write, read and speak. And we are also proud to record through the efforts of Dr. Sindhu P. Nair, Dr. Jalja Kumari, Dr. Prasita Unni Krishna and Ms. Sujini, we are able to translate the today's proceedings of our guest of honor's headquarters speech in Hindi into Malayalam language. And Tolik official language seminar or meeting participation was also a constant event at RC Cochin, implying that we always give importance to the national language. And the one student, one trip program was successful only through the efforts of some coordinators who donated some of their samplings which they got for their environment day for this purpose. And besides, the block development office at Mulanthurthi who gave free samplings, around 250 samplings were given, and totally we could plant around 285 samplings. The other 35 were donated by the other LSCs. And the term and examination conducted to have objectivity of purpose, we have the observers deputed. There were around 21 observers deputed across on an average for the last two June and December term and examination in 2019. And we have around 57,758 and 83,098 examinees per course for the June and December term and examination under RC Cochin. And we are, for the June 2019, we have uploaded around 43,534 awards, meaning for each assignment there will be one award, so entry of each award and validation was done. The December is under process, so I am not reporting it in this report. And the project reports, internship reports are also evaluated at Regional Centre Cochin. And for the June 2019, we have around 204 reports uploaded. And for the December, it is around 176. Similarly, for the internship records, for the June, it was 134. And for the December 2019, it is 107. And related to the new initiatives of the university of payment of the the concession given for down opting for e-content of the study material still continues, and we do encourage people, students, when they come through the help desk to opt for this so that they are benefited economically also when they join the IGNOU program. And the online application for the empanelment of academic counselor and evaluators is also possible through the help desk available at the Regional Center Cochin. And as sir told, all the three gold medals, there's two from Cochin and one from Vatakara, they have not joined us, but still we are happy that our students are also one among the prime when it comes to pass out. And even the last year convocation, the chief guest at headquarters was highlighting about Swayam. And even today, the chief guest was telling about Swayam. And if you have not visited the Swayam platform, at least for once, I encourage you to visit. It is more like you have to keep your Gmail account open and visit this website so that you can access the content. And like a photo gallery in your any phone, this each programs are visible. And when you click the video, you will note about the short review of each program. And the uniqueness is you can study at your own pace and time. And the exam questions are also objective, and the internal assignment are also objective. So that is the uniqueness. So we should take benefit. And when it was launched, our Prime Minister sir told that in another 5 years, when it comes to employment, the credit given to Swayam also will be weighed down. And almost in all metropolitan cities, already autonomous colleges have forced people to take Swayam courses instead of the regular college courses in the option itself. when they take the admission. So as a distance learner, as sir was telling, to teach is to touch one's life forever. So whether it is a distance learning or conventional education system, some of the benefits which are given by the government are common for both the sectors. So as a distance learner, we should make use of this SWAYAM program. And when it comes to study or a take home message from me will be, when it comes to study, take one day at a time. And it is only all problems related to one education will be solvable. That is the uniqueness of a problem encountered in education. And when it comes to what to do next in education, enroll and don't worry about tomorrow. I wish you all the best and we look forward to have you again for some other program with us. Thank you.
Thank you very much, ma'am. Regional Centre Cochin and Regional Centre Vatakara is extremely happy to have a very renowned, very distinguished elite personality with us, who is Dr. A. Ramachandran, Honorable Vice-Chancellor of Fisheries and Ocean Studies at Cochin. May I most respectfully request our guest of honor to give the convocation address.
A warm good afternoon and greetings to one and all. Respected regional directors of IGNOU regional centers, Dr. J.S. Dorothy, regional director Cochin, Dr. M. Rajesh, regional director Vatakara, academics, employees of the regional centers, coordinators of IGNOU learner support centers, the distinguished guests present here, correspondents from print and electronic media, and my dear IGNOU students. It is indeed a proud privilege for me to be here amidst you for the 33rd convocation ceremony of this prestigious university, Indira Gandhi Open National Open University, popularly known as IGNOU, the People's University. At the outset, I would like to congratulate all the graduating learners for the successful completion of their academic programs. IGNOU, known to be the largest university in the world, has made significant contributions in democratizing higher education in the country by providing access to large number of aspirants through the open and distance form. This is attested by the fact that this mega university today serves the educational aspirations of over 3 million students in India and other countries through 21 schools of studies and a network of 67 regional centers, around 2,667 learner support centers and 29 overseas partner institutions. I am delighted to note that this university is offering 228 academic programs ranging from certificate, diploma, graduate degree, postgraduate degree and doctorate programs to cater to the educational aspirations of a very large clientele of lifelong learners, not only in India but also at an international level through the partner institutions. It is indeed heartening to learn that learners who enroll in IGNOU represent the very profile of our social society, as there are housewives, employed class, professionals, technocrats, administrative officers, entrepreneurs, researchers, young students, senior citizens, jailmates, inmates, to name a few. I congratulate IGNOU for continuously striving to build an inclusive knowledge society through inclusive education and thereby making significant contributions to the human resource development of this country. I am happy to learn that the university in the 33rd convocation being held today is awarding over 2 lakh degrees, diplomas and certificates to the learners who have successfully completed their respective programs of study. It is interesting to learn that the main function is conducted at IGNOU headquarters at New Delhi and also simultaneously at 39 regional centers in the country. Gold medals are also awarded to over 78 meritorious students in this convocation. Dr. Ramesh Pokhriyal Nishank, Honorable Minister, Human Resource Development, Government of India, in his address has appreciated IGNOU for having unprecedented expertise in developing and launching academic programs that are needed in the present day context and deeply useful for learning community. In this address, he also stated that the government is creating avenues for enhancing gross enrollment ratio of the country to 50%. In this context, IGNOU and similar institutes have an important role to play. It is a pleasure to note that IGNOU Regional Center, Cochin, since its establishment on 17th November 1988, has been continuously striving to provide open and distance education in the state of Kerala and the Union Territory of Lakshadweep. Over the years, the activities of IGNOU in the region grew and a number of study centers were established with substantial student enrollment in various academic programs of the university. I am happy to note that presently, there are 34 learner support centers under the regional center. It is noteworthy to mention that the regional center of Cochin, with the current jurisdiction of 6 districts, Alappuzha, Ernakulam, Kottayam, Idukki, Palakkad, Trichur, and the Union Territory of Lakshadweep, has been able to attain student registration of 25,340 learners in the year 2019. Regional Center Vatakara, since its inception in the year 2011 and with the current jurisdiction of 5 districts, Kannur, Kasargod, Wayanad, Kozhikode, Malappuram and Union Territory of Mahi, is also making significant contribution to higher education through open and distance education catering to the educational aspirations of learners of North Malabar region. I am pleased to learn that from regional centers Cochin and Vatakara, 3 students are eligible to receive the gold medals from IGNOU headquarters from Honorable Minister of HRD, Government of India. I congratulate each of them on this great achievement. I am extremely happy to learn that there are 6,182 learners being conferred degrees, diplomas, certificates for this 33rd convocation under the Cochin Regional Center and Vatakara Regional Center. Dear students of this mega university, this convocation is a significant milestone in your academic life. The degrees and awards earned by each one of you is a result of your relentless hard work and immense dedication. Hence, it is indeed a proud moment for all of you, as much as it is for your academic counselors, guides, functionaries of learning support centers, family members and parents. May your quest for higher learning continue all through your professional life. Learning, as you will agree, is a lifelong process. May the knowledge and expertise gained through the program of study with IGNOU empower and motivate you to explore new horizon of knowledge. Education is the ability to meet life situation. It is a character building process, enhancing one's personality and making him or her rational, capable, responsive and intelligent. India has had a very rich heritage of higher education, which goes back to about 6,000 years from the Vedic period, that is BC 1000 to 600 onwards. In its size and diversity, India has the third largest higher education system in the world, next only to China and United States. The demand for higher education and the magnitude of planned reforms is growing considerably in India, with over 50% of its population below the age of 25. This has created a huge demand and responsibility to transform India as a leading hub for higher education in the world to cater the needs of this ever-growing population. Despite significant progress over the last 10 years, Indian higher education is faced with four broad challenges. The supply demand gap. India has a low rate of enrollment in higher education at only 23.6% at present, compared with 32% in China and 36% in Brazil. There is enormous unmet demand for higher education. The Indian government aims to achieve 30% this year and 50% in the years to come. The low quality of teaching and learning. The system is beset by issues of quality in many of its institutions. A chronic shortage of faculty, poor quality of teaching, outdated and rigid curricula and pedagogy, lack of accountability and quality assurance, and separation of research and teaching. These are some of the issues we face. Constraints on research capacity and innovation is another major issue. With a very low level of PhD enrollment, less than 1%, India does not have enough high quality researchers. There are few opportunities for interdisciplinary and multidisciplinary working. Lack of early stage research experience, a weak ecosystem for innovation, and low levels of industry engagement. Uneven growth and access to opportunity is another issue we face. Socially, India remains highly divided. Access to higher education is uneven, with multidimensional inequalities in enrollment across population groups and geographies. Three central pillars of government's plan for education reflects these realities: expansion, equity and excellence. Over next few decades, every aspect of higher education is being reorganized and remodeled. Funding, leadership and management, quality assurance, accountability, relationships with industry, international collaboration and the way teaching and research are conducted. Emphasis will be placed on strengthening existing institutions and research are conducted. Now, IGNOU plays a significant role in expansion, equity and excellence. That's a great relief for the country. My dear students, while successful completion of your academic program is a matter of pride and joy, definitely, it is also a stepping stone to the opportunities and challenges that lie ahead of you in the future. We live in an era where technology transition is happening at a very rapid pace. Every day, few concepts are being introduced, established paradigms are being advanced, and research and development is providing new vistas for further explorations and application. As a graduate, one needs to assimilate the latest developments of your specific discipline and strive to make meaningful contributions to the society and thereby for national development. I am sure you will make full use of the knowledge and skills acquired through your program of study with IGNOU for the well-being of the society of the nation. I recall the words of Honorable Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam. I quote, "The purpose of education is to make good human beings with skills and expertise. May your degree unlock many doors for you. May the degrees earned further facilitate each one of you to continue to be good human beings with compassion for the needy, conviction for the righteous, and zeal to hold good virtues in life. I once again congratulate the IGNOU regional centers, Cochin and Vatakara, for the best efforts and contributions being made in the field of open and distance education in the state of Kerala. My best wishes to IGNOU to scale greater heights in the future. May a greater number of learners be able to fulfill their educational attainments from this great institution in times to come. I also once again congratulate all the meritorious students who are receiving the degrees today. In the end, I wish every IGNOU graduate present here and who received degree in absentia a successful and satisfying career, good health, prosperity, and success in all your endeavors. God bless you. Thank you very much.
Thank you. English, MBA, DMM. Serial number 9, H. Sunish Kumar. Number 10, Rasina P. Number 12, Shijilas KP. Number 14, Munira K. Thank you.
24, Sindhu, TE. AY 28 Anish PJ 31 Salina P 34 Subeda UV. Subeda UV. 36 Annapurna M.
Close.
38 Amarjot M.
Center.
39 Silja B. 41 Meena VP. 42 Sapna. 44 Nashida E. 134 Neetu K. 137 Sajivon CS. Sajivon CS. 154 Sajini IK. 156 Mary Sebastian. 160 Chella Hanla. 168 NPS student Muhammad Vaseem M. 172 MSO student Hashim Afsal T. 173 Manoj Kumar NK. 174, Disha Moore Thomas. NTTX student, 176, Anaga Sadishu TM. We come to the students, to the end of the students from counter 1. I request my colleague Dr. V.T. Janjakumari, Assistant Director, to kindly call out the names of the students of counter 2.
These are the names of the students from counter number 2. The students are MAH, MCA, MCO, PGD, IBO. Can we call the number name, first one? Number 1, Mohammed Rashid M. Number 1, Mohammed Rashid M. MH, MCA, MCOP, PGD, IBO students, you may please come forward. Dear students, after receiving your certificates in Mohammed Rashid M. of MAH. Number 2, MAH Gigi Kara. Gigi Kara, please come.
Mohammed Rashid
Next is Sultan Prasid. Number 87, Anuja R. Anuja R. PGD ABU Annual Book Certificates. Next is 98. That is Subhanya B. Subhanya B. Muhammad Rishan, Muhammad Saeed, Muhammad Haris. Subhanya B. Muhammad Rishan. Muhammad Rishan. Number 100, Muhammad Saeed.
Vinaya AS
Jayashree D. 122 Priya Prasad. 123 Nisi Salam. 124 Shanti Joseph.